When I began my 3D journey, there was no 3D animation school here and social media wasn't as broad as it is today. So I really struggled in order to get into the production field, especially animation. So I totally understand others who find themselves in the same situation. Maybe you don't have the money to attend a 3D school or there is none around you, so doing it online has become your last resort. I'm going to be honest with you. Learning this without an individual help might somehow or sometimes be tough, but I have gathered enough information to make this journey much easier for you. I'm going to give you a step-by-step beginner's approach into the 3D world in order for you to have a detailed understanding on how 3D animation works. Before we get talking, can you be a part of the first 20 people watching this video to check the link in my description below to download a free PDF book on 3D animation for raw beginners on Maya. There's also another one for Blender users as well. I've placed something at the end of this video for 3ds Max users as well, so kindly stick around to the end of this video. Without wasting much time, the fact that you have a computer and a couple of softwares installed doesn't mean you are ready to embark on this journey. The idea of learning animation in less than a year or two is kind of weird. You should be looking at a good 4 to 5 or 6 years with consistent practice in order to have a smooth leveled knowledge on all the basics and also the kind of software you are able to work in fluidly. Before making 3D animation a career choice, you might want to ask yourself these few questions. Are you willing to invest time, effort, and money into this career? After having these thoughts, consider your situation, skills, and why you want to pursue this career choice before threading on this path. If the idea of animation sounds like a hobby to you, then you wouldn't have to worry about what I said or what I'm about to say. But for the career-minded people, let's talk. Before I get into the basic principles you need to know in order to kickstart your 3D journey, I would like to say most people have limited knowledge on what exactly animation is. The 3D world is very broad. You can choose this career path because you want to get into gaming, 3D printing, animation, VR, visual effects, architectural visualization, and many more. No matter which field you get into, the basics of 3D animation is what should be focused on the most. There is 2D animation and 3D animation. 2D animation is also a broad topic, and for that matter, I would like to tackle that in another video. But for those of you who want to jump straight into 3D, kindly keep these in mind. You don't need to have any knowledge in 2D animation or drawing in order to start 3D animation. It's 100% possible to become a good 3D animator without any 2D or drawing background. But hey, it's a plus to know how to draw and 2D animate. If you have the money and time, I would advise you start from there. Now let's talk about the basics. Knowing art, painting, drawing, photography, cinematography, sculpting, modeling, texturing, and lighting will be the best fundamental basics for any 2D or 3D animator. But for those of you who only want to focus on 3D animation, I would encourage you to ignore all that and just focus on modeling, texturing, and lighting. As a raw beginner, to have a good foundation in 3D, you might want to tackle modeling for maybe 3 months non-stop, then you move on to texturing, maybe another 2 months, and then you end up on lighting. You can spend a good 3 months on lighting. These months are just for you to have the basics on how 3D works and what goes into it. From there, your foundation would be established. Notice I didn't mention any of the secondary, such as sculpting, rigging, UV editing, shading, animation, compositing, and all that. It's because not everybody wants to animate a moving character, rig, or composite. You can go ahead and focus on them though after you are done with the basic modeling, texturing, and lighting. Whilst you get good with the basics, add a little bit of advanced cinematography. Spend maybe a good 3 months studying cinematography. That would help you know how to light subjects, objects and environments, camera distance, camera movement and camera angles, and a few others. Note this, a freelancer needs to have a solid understanding on the basics, a fair idea on each of the secondary, and also a very good understanding on cinematography. I know most people who only focus on any of the secondaries and hit hard on them for a living, so they could only be compositing for a living, rigging for a living, or sculpting for a living. It's not a bad idea, but you get very limited and might have a hard time finding a job, especially if your skills isn't too unique. If you want to appeal to the wider market, then you need to master the basics and secondary. Animation takes a lot of time and shouldn't be rushed. Just chill and go through all the process one after the other and constantly keep practicing and you would be good. Okay, let's talk about software. I would like to break this part into two sections, freelancing and working for a company. Before I mention any software, I would like to say it doesn't really matter what kind of software you use. I hope you get this one. Software isn't the biggest problem here. Knowing the fundamentals of 3D animation, being artistic and technical can get you into any company, especially if they love your work. Those companies might even go an extra mile to teach you their software so you can be a part of their company. So your skills are more important than the software you go in for. But hey, most people will still want to know what software will suit them. So let's talk. If you want to go freelancing, then Blender would make your journey way easier. But in order for you to have a broad knowledge and be able to extend your territory, kindly add 3ds Max and Maya to Blender. This would make it easier if you find yourself in a company that doesn't use Blender at all. So be smart, make some money off using Blender if you are freelancing at the moment and start studying 3ds Max or Maya. I'm not going to talk about Cinema 4D or Houdini because over the years, those two softwares have gripped a portion of the industries for themselves. Houdini for simulation, ZBrush for sculpting, Katana for lighting, and also Cinema 4D for motion graphics. Okay, doing away with the freelancing, let's talk about people who want to work for a company. If your main goal is to work for a company, then you actually don't need Blender as your primary software. Bigger dreams, bigger investment. Jump into Maya or 3ds Max. There's Maya for students and also Houdini for indies, which cost less. I'm not saying people using Blender don't have bigger dreams. I'm only trying to place both the freelancer and the aspiring company worker in a comfortable position so everybody can be happy. Okay, up to this point, if you have questions or anything that I have not spoken about, or maybe I might not even talk about them, kindly leave them in the comment section below and I'll be glad to answer you. Let's talk about online forums and courses. Showcasing your work for feedback is very important. I'm actually making a video on some of the best forums you can join and meet some of the top tier ILM and Weta Digital workers you can actually communicate with for tips and also feedbacks on your works you post, which would actually be a booster for you and your career, especially taking feedbacks from such people. Online classes are very important. Watching tutorials on YouTube isn't enough and sometimes can be very confusing. You need a mentor who can take his or her time to teach you everything you need to know. There are very good online schools out there you can search and join. Let's talk about computer. As a beginner, I'm assuming you want to start with what you have. Then as time goes on, you save some money and make some upgrades here and there. But if you have the money to go in for a computer right now and start, then I would like you to check out a video I made on the best GPUs, CPUs, RAM, for 3D animation. Links in the description below. The last thing I would like to talk about is taking criticism. Let me say this to people who don't animate but enjoy watching other people's animation. If you want to comment on somebody's work, I would suggest you do that respectfully. Highlight what you didn't like about it, and also if you have knowledge in 3D animation, kindly share your thoughts peacefully and decently with them. But to throw someone for a work he's shared and not contributing to how well he or she can improve it is absolutely nonsense. There are certain people who are born to troll on people's efforts. As a 3D animator, you would encounter such people. I would advise you get close to two or three sincere people who understand animation you can share your works with before posting them online as a beginner. Take those two or three people's feedbacks in good faith and build upon it. Don't let the online trolls get to you. It's your work, and guess what? It's not going to look that uncool forever. Keep practicing over and over, and you will be exactly where you want to be in 6 to 7 years time. 3D animation requires a lot of time, effort, and investment. Remember, the production field is very broad, and if you aren't sure if it's really 3D you want to pursue, then you should take some time off to explore more to see if there are others you might do better in than 3D. I really appreciate everyone who spent time through this boring video. I had to cut out a lot because the video was getting so long. If you are a 3ds Max user, then I have left a complete video course for raw beginners you can download for free in the description below. I have also left lots of details in the description box which might benefit others. Okay, if you love this video, kindly don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video to other friends who might benefit from the 3ds Max complete tutorials. Until my next video, peace out.